You trade options, whether you sell options or buy options, and you have struggled to find the best strike price positioning or strike price levels. I'm about to share with you the secret indicator that will heighten your options trading. So if you like the sound of that, all I ask for is that you smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe. So what is this mysterious secret indicator? And that is pivot points. So what are pivot points? Pivot points are natural support and resistance zones where it's done by a simple classic formula. Now there are different levels. There's the actual pivot point, and then you got support 1, 2, and 3, and resistance 1, 2, and 3. What I'll be talking about in this video is purely pivot points, and all pivot points are is whatever date range you're looking at. It takes the previous high plus the previous low plus the previous close divided by 3. And that is a static line that does not change for the given period that you are trying to calculate. And what we're going to do in this video, we're going to use Microsoft as an example, looking at daily pivots and showing you how accurate daily pivots are in not only being hit on the week or the day that they were created, but also how you can use those to determine what your strike prices are. So what you need is you need a trading platform that has obviously charts and stuff, but also has a pivot indicator built in. Now TradingView has this built in by as standard. So if you're new to TradingView, the link is down below to check that one out. All you need to do is type in pivot points, and it's pivot point standard is what you need. And when you go on to pivot point standard, you will have all these other different settings. So all you need to do is hit the traditional method of the calculation that I just walked through with you guys. Your time frame, you can do daily pivots, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly. I'm sticking with weekly because I traditionally sell weekly options. Periods to go back is not that relevant because we're always looking forward. And you know your colors and your lines and all those kind of different things. So all I've done is shown the label for P for pivot, but you don't even need that. And I've taken off all the other ones because by default, I think all the S1s to S3s and R1s to R3s are selected. Now, before we talk about what's going on with current price action, and so we're on the hourly on Microsoft, I'm just going to show you. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, last 6 days, right? So what you can see over here, right? And this first one is not a good example to prove my point, but it shows what I'm talking about. So the pivot point for whatever time frame you're looking at is normally hit 75 percent of the time. Right, so 75% or more, in this case, the weekly pivot is hit on the week it was created. Now, this week, on this last one that we're talking about here, you can see that this is the start of the week, this is the end of the week. You can see through here that price never touched this particular pivot. But we'll come back to that in a second. The next week, you can see here that price was at a high over here, came right into its pivot level, and then continued lower. The third week, we had the opening over here, it rose up to its pivot level there. Then we've got the fourth week, it opened, it pretty much gapped down right onto its pivot level and continued going down for the day. Just get rid of some of these drawings and move this across. And then you can see here that on this one, pivot was hit, and we will talk about these two. And this is last week, and this is the current week where we are now. So as you can see, majority of the time is there. Now, if we go back to the first one we talked about here, that this pivot was not hit. You can see 1, 2, 3 days later, on the third day, that this pivot was actually hit. So that resistance line, support line, whatever you want to call it, was hit at that particular level. So when I say that it's hit 75% of the time that the week it was created, it's about 90% plus over the given 4 to 5 weeks later, your pivot is going to be hit. So even if you're looking at longer expiration dates when you sell or buy options and you're looking at a pivot point, again, generally speaking, majority of the time, given the next month or so, this pivot point will be hit. Yes, there are missed pivots. So you take this one here. So this one missed it on the day it was on the week it was created, but the next week after it was hit. So this is classified as a missed pivot, and then the next week it was hit. So it took 1 week for that to do. And these are weeks, not days, sorry. No, these are days. And then so you got 1 week, then you got one, two, the third week it was hit. So now if we go now to last week and this week, these are classic example. So let's just say when this bar opened over here, this long doji candle, on the time of opening, it draws this pivot. So this pivot only comes in when the market opens for that particular week. So we obviously can't see next week's pivot because it has to take the full week's worth of data to draw the pivot. So it will take the high of the week, the low of the week, the close of the week, add those together, divide by three, and it will draw the line across there. And what you so we so this line, when this candle was just started, this line would have been available to us. Now we can then start looking at, let's say we were bullish on Microsoft or we wanted to sell puts on Microsoft to get a bit of premium. We could have used a pivot point level as an example of making sure that we sell a cash secured put at least below that level, right? So the pivot was around the 273 mark, and I think it just actually missed it from memory. What's the low of this bar? 272. Yeah, so it did. It just hit it. It just shows how much that these pivot points are also used as support and resistance zones. So you can see that start all the way there, and then at 271, 272, price got hit and then used it as support and then started to rally up. So if I was looking at this, I would be looking to sell puts below the 270 level to give myself what I call a line of defense, right? You're trying to put as many bricks in front of price as you possibly can because you don't want to be assigned. You just want to take the premium when kind of selling options. Or if you're buying an option, so if you're buying an option at this level, I would be buying options, at the 273 mark, right? I'd be selling above the strike. So when it goes down and gets to this level, this option will be worth a lot more, and then I will sell out the option. So, and what you're seeing here is the kind of the same thing. We're in this uptrend now on the hourly chart, this bullish move up, and we have a position here of where we can either sell an option below the probably the 275 mark just to give ourselves a bit more cushion, because you can see that in this example price can actually pull breakthrough pivots, but you can see there's some good support there, resistance there, and again even with this first hourly bar of this particular day, again uses it as a support zone to propel itself up. So if we have a look at the options chain for this week, so we've got the 28, let's call it the 280 mark. Let's have a look at the 278 option. So I'm on Yahoo Finance, got their option chain. You can see I'm on August 12th, a week out. If I go down, even the 275, even $1.20, so $120. So what's that? 1.2 divided by, what was that? 2700. Is that right? 275. So that is, nearly half a percent return in a week. Probably not the best return, but I'm just illustrating a point. Or what you could do, you could buy what we got here. Let's say you want to buy like the 282 or something like that, or 280. Let's see what that looks like. 280, $240 trade. On Microsoft, hoping for a move for it to break down into this level and hopefully touch the pivot point. So again, I'm not even testing this out. Let's just look at Tesla as a particular example. So you got Tesla again. You see this? It made a move up here. It pulled back. touched its weekly pivot and then move on. This week here, it's already touched its pivot point. So if we go to Meta, Meta's had a massive move up here, 4%. I'm definitely in the money in my call option here, which definitely isn't good. But you can see it. So here's another good example, right? You got a missed pivot over here. All right, missed it completely because you had a gap down on earnings. Got to this level here, hit its pivot, and then didn't hit it. Didn't hit this missed pivot. Second week straight from the open, you know, it's gone here. So we might have a potential missed pivot one here today. But again, I probably wouldn't. This one here, the move's already gone for me. You want something that's close enough. Again, if I was to sell options on Meta, I would probably be doing it at the 163 mark. Well, what I would probably do is wait for a pullback on that one there. Let's look at Apple. Apple again, you know, consolidate around this pivot level for most of the week before taking off. Again, here similar to Microsoft, looking for pullbacks at the 164 mark, or whether you're buying a put above, selling a put below. Those are the kind of things that we would want to be looking at for this particular one. But hit. Look, you see how accurate these levels actually are here of, you know, support and resistance right there, right there, right there. Apple respects it pretty well. So again, you can use this. No one's talking about this as part of their trading, which I find really interesting. So it's something that I've been using for a while now, along with the Greeks and various other things. But again, it's another tool that you guys can use. So make sure you click the TradingView link down below so you can kind of, you know, put the pivot point standard on there. And I've got other videos on the screen now of other option strategies, but I'm sure you'll check out where you can use this particular strategy. And I'll see you in the next video.